गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल टीच यू क्लास 10th मैथमेटिक्स क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन पार्ट 2. सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट द बेसिक ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन दैट इज आस्क्ड इन द बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन. सो हियर इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन गिवन. सॉल्व द इक्वेशन 2x माइनस 1 बाई एक्स इज इक्वल टू 7. राइट योर आंसर करेक्ट टू 2 डेसिमल places. Okay, so students, see here, how will you solve? Students, you are saying that this is written as 2x minus 1 by x is equal to 7. So you know what is the general formula of quadratic equation. It is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. First we will convert this into this form. Okay, now see here, what you will do, you take LCM, it will be x. Okay, and if you solve this, it will be 2x multiply x, 2x square and 1 multiply 1 is equal to 7. Okay, now again you do cross multiplication, you will get here 2x square minus 1 is equal to 7x. Students, you are seeing that here in the general formula, in the right side it is 0. So you have to make this as there should be right in the right side. It should be 0. Okay, so it will be 2x square minus 7x minus 1 equals 0. Now you have to find the value of a, b and c. Now you will compare this. Okay, comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. If you compare, you will get a is equal to 2 and b is equal to minus 7 and c is equal to minus 1. Students, you have to solve this. I have told you two methods to solve the quadratic equation. First is the by factorizing and second is the quadratic formula. Students, you have to find it to the correct two decimal place. So you will use the quadratic formula. Okay, now you know x is equal to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Okay, now you are seeing that this is the minus and the value of b is minus 7 plus minus under root b square, that means minus 7 square minus 4 multiply a means 2 and c means minus 1. Okay, upon 2 multiply a is given here 2. Okay, so it will be 7 plus minus under root minus 7 square will be 49 and this will be minus minus plus and 4 to the 8 upon 4. So it will be 7 plus minus under root 57 upon 4. So students, you are saying that this is the root 57. So you have to find the square root of this number, okay, up to 2 decimal place. So how will you find here? See, this is 57 given. You can put here point and then after many zeros as you want. Okay, if you have to find the square root of this number, you have to make pair. You have to make pair in the left of the decimal and in the right of the decimal. Okay, now you know how it is solved. You have to take the square number. So also, what number you will take? You will take here 7. So 7 7 ja, it will be 49. Okay, and if you subtract it, this what you will get? You will get 8. Okay, and you can put here 00 because pair numbers are taken. Okay, you are taking the decimal numbers, so you have to put a decimal here and you know the same number is added here. Okay, you will get here 14. So which number you will take here? You will take 5, and if you take 5, what you will get? Okay, and 5 1 are 5 2 7. Okay, if you subtract this, that you will get here 5 and 7. Okay, now put here 5. Okay, it will be 150 and you have to take this pair. Okay, so which number you will take? You can take here 4. Okay, so you will get here what? Okay, friends, if you subtract this, you will get here 10 minus 6 4 and here 9 minus 1 8. Okay, and this will be 4. Okay, so students, you have to find up to the 2 decimal place, you are getting 7.54. okay, now You know that this is the quadratic equation and there are two roots. So what the roots will be? So you have to take the positive sign and then after the negative sign. So students, if you take positive sign, taking positive sign, you will get x is equal to 7 plus 7.54, because root 7 value is root 57 value is what you have got, 7.54, okay, upon 4. If you add this, you will get here 14.54 upon 4, and if you divide this, what you will get? 4 3 12, okay, and 4 6 24, and 4 3 12, okay, and 4 5 20. Now students, you have to find this answer up to the two decimal places, correct? So you are seeing that here the decimal is at the third place. So students, if the decimal is at the third place and if it is 5 or more than 5, the previous one is added by 1, okay? So you can write this as 3.64, okay? Correct to two decimal place. Okay, and now if you take negative sign, you will get here x is equal to 7 minus 7.54 upon 4. If you subtract this, you will get minus 0.54 upon 4. And if you divide this, you will get here minus 0.135. And if you take up to the correct two decimal place, you can write this as 0.14, okay? Okay, now students, you have seen that here your answer is 3.64 and minus 0.14. So you can write this as your answer will be, or the solution set will be 3.64 and minus 0.14. Okay, so this question is very important. Like this, many questions are given in your book. You can try to solve this, okay? Now students, see here the second question. Second question is given here. Without solving the following equation, find the value of P for which the roots are real and equal. And the equation is given here, Px square minus 4x plus 3 is equal to 0. So students, this is also very important question. It is asked in the previous years, okay? Now see here, how will you solve? So students, your equation is given here, Px square minus 4x plus 3 is equal to 0. First, you have to compare this with Ax square plus Bx plus C is equal to 0, okay? So comparing with Ax square plus Bx plus C is equal to 0. When you will compare, you are seeing that this is x square, this is also x square. So what will be the value of A? It will be P, okay? And the value of B will be minus 4, and the value of C will be 3, okay? So students, in this question, it is given that roots are real and equal, okay? So students, I have told you in my previous video, the roots will be real and equal when D is equal to 0, okay? So you know that here D is equal to B square minus 4AC, okay? So you are seeing that what is the value of B? Minus 4. So you have to take here minus 4 square minus 4 multiply A is P and C is 3, okay? Minus 4 square will be 16 and this will be minus 12P. Since in the given question the roots are real and equal, so we will write here, since the roots are real and equal, therefore D is equal to 0. Students, here you are seeing that here D is what? 16 minus 12P. So it will be 16 minus 12P equals 0, okay? And you have to solve this you will get, it will be 12p is equal to 16. You can write this as 12p is equal to 16. So p is equal to what? 16 upon 12. And if you simplify this, you will get here 4 upon 3. Okay, students. So you have got here the value of p is equal to 4 upon 3. So I hope that you understand. Like this, many questions are asked in the previous year. You can try. Okay. Now, students, see here the next question, the third question. The third question is also very important because it is asked in the examination. So this question is, without solving the following equation, find the value of m for which the roots are real and equal. And your equation is given, x square plus 2 within bracket m minus 1 x plus m plus 5 is equal to 0. Now, students, how will you solve this? You have to again compare this with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Okay. So see your solution, 2 m minus 1 x plus m plus 5 equals 0. Okay. Comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. When you compare, you will get here a is equal to 1 because 1 is written here, okay, and b is equal to 2 m minus 1 and c is equal to m plus 5. Students, in this question you have to find the value of m and you have given condition roots are real and equal. Okay, so first you have to find the value of d, and that is b square minus 4ac. okay, you are seeing that the value of b is 2 within bracket m minus 1, it will be whole square minus 4 multiply a means 1 and c means m plus 5. Okay, you will square this. Okay, so it will be 2 square m minus 1 whole square minus, if you multiply this, you will get here minus 4m minus 20. Okay, and it will be what? 4 multiply, you know, a minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2ab. You will use this formula. So you will write here m square plus 1 square minus 2 multiply m multiply 1 minus 4m minus 20. Okay. So it will be m square plus 1 minus 2m minus 4m minus 20. So it will be 4m square plus 4 minus 8m minus 4m minus 20. Okay, now you are seeing that this is 4m square and minus 8m minus 4m, it will be minus 12m, and 4 minus 20 will be minus 16. Okay, so the value of d, you are getting this. Now in this question it is given that roots are real and equal. So when the roots are real and equal, I have told you, when d is 0, the roots will be real and equal. So since roots are real and equal, okay, therefore d is equal to 0, and value of d is given here, 4m square minus 12m minus 16 is equal to 0. You can take common here 4, so it will be m square minus 3m minus 4 is equal to 0. Okay, you can write this 3m minus 4 is equal to 0, because when 4 is good, 4 we take in the right side, okay, you will get here 0. Now you know how it is factorized. You are saying that this is 4, so you have to take two factors of 4 such that their sum should be 3. Okay, so the factor you can take 2 multiply 2, 3 multiply 1. Okay, but if you add this, okay, this will be 2 plus 2, 4. Okay, and 2 to the 4, and 3 multiply 1, it will be 3. Okay, now you can take also this 4 multiply 1. Okay, and 4 minus 1 will be 3. Okay, so you can write here m square plus m minus 4m minus 4 equals 0. Okay, you can write, because 1m minus 4m will be minus 3m. Okay, if you take here common m, you will get m plus 1, and if you take here common minus 4, you will get m plus 1 equals 0. Okay, so if you take m plus 1 common, you will get m minus 4 equals 0. Students, you are seeing that here the multiplication of both the numbers are 0. Okay, either this or this number will be 0. Okay, so you can write this m plus 1 equals 0 or m minus 4 equals 0. If you solve this, you will get minus 1, and if you solve this, you will get 4. Okay, so there will be two values of m, okay, for which the roots will be real and equal. Okay, so this will be your answer, m equals minus 1 or m equals 4. Okay students, I hope that you understand this question. Like this, many questions are asked in your examination. You can practice them.